Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. So here I took the balloon. I applied a little bit of Vaseline on it so I can wrap the nylon easily and it will stay stick on the balloon. And this is very common thing, all YouTubers have been doing the same thing to make the bowl from the newspaper. So this is what I'm going to do actually, in short words I can say. So I will wrap the nylon around the ball, around the balloon actually, and then I will start to stick the newspapers while using the white glue all around this balloon. Yeah, here I have white glue. I have mixed the glue in water a little bit to make a mixture, and I have cut some newspaper pieces as well to stick it all over the balloon, and I will leave it to dry completely. So after applying the newspapers, I decided to cover all the ball, all the bowl, whatever, with the tissues. So if there is any place left, I could not apply the enough newspapers on it, so it will be going covered by the white piece of tissue. So I decided to cover all the balloon with the tissues after applying the newspapers, and it's just optional, you don't need to do this. If you think you should do, you can do it. So then I started to cover it with the glue again, and I will leave them to dry completely. Yeah, here it's almost dry. So now I will pop the balloon by using the needle or the scissor to cut it out, and then I will remove it from inside smoothly so I don't damage the paper. So because I need to make leaves by using the air dry clay, and I don't have this size, big size of mold to make the leaf with the clay, so I decided to make my own way to make the leaves. I draw the leaf shape on a piece of cardboard, then I will cut it the shape, and then I will draw the complete leaf layers or roots on this piece of cardboard here, and then I will start to use the hot glue on top of these lines so I can get the texture of the leaf. But if you have the mold, exact mold for the leaves, that's much easier, but I was not having, so I decided to use it to make it in my way. So here what I'm doing now, I've applied the hot glue on top of the lines I draw. So here is air dry clay and little bit of white glue to stick the leaves on top of that bowl. So I started to roll the clay a little bit to make it thin enough. Then I stick the cardboard piece on top of the clay and I will roll it out a little bit more so it can press down the clay to get the texture of the leaf. And then with the knife I will cut off the rough sides of the leaf like this. And here you will get the shape of the leaf somehow, but I loved it. Anyway, if you have the complete shape, the mold, that's easy, but here this was working as well. So I removed it from the paper, from the sheet, and here you can see it's almost a thing what I wanted to get. So then I will start to use air dry clay on top of the bowl by using some white glue. I will stick the white glue on the back side of the leaf and then I will start to stick it on the bowl. And I will cover like this the complete bowl by using the different positions of the leaves in different ways, not in the same row or in same lines. By using it's like they are falling over each other, the shape of the leaves. So yeah, you will see next step what I'm actually doing. So make sure you are not making all the leaves in one time and then you start to stick them on the bowl, because in this timing the air dry clay can get dry and it will be difficult to turn the leaves around the bowl. So I was making only 3 to 4 pieces of leaves in one time, then I started to stick it, then I start to make more leaves, 3 and 4 pieces again, then I started to stick around the bowl again. So you don't need to make all the leaves in one time because the air dry clay will dry completely and it will be difficult to give the shape. So here you can see I was putting them in the different positions, not in same row or same style. My white glue, I mean white clay got finished, so I use this color clay, that's why you see the leaves are different in this way, different color actually. So anyway, it's dry completely. Then I took scissor and I will start to cut the spaces between the leaves, which I left them empty because I mean to do it. But anyway, if you will put the leaves in any position, there will be staying the space between each leaf. So you will cut it off once it's completely dry, everything of course. Then I will then I'm cutting it here by using the small tiny thin scissor. so it can easily go through the leaves space. And remember, the bottom of the bowl I left it empty without any leaves, because of course we want it to stand, so I left it empty. I didn't apply any leaf on the bottom part. So here, like this, you will cut all of the spaces between the leaves. Here you can see I have cut it all the spaces. And then here I have green color paint. You can use actually acrylic paint, but I was not having acrylic paint. This was the paint, oil paint something. The carpenters or the furniture people, they use it for I have no idea actually. It was very sticky and oily paint. So this one was available on that time at home, so I used this one, and it was quite nice finishing also with this, because it was having oily texture. So once I applied the color on all over the leaves, it started to give the shine, and it made the clay more smooth and shiny, glossy. So I was quite happy with the result, because the acrylic paint will not give you that much shine. But that's fine. If you use acrylic paint, you can spray it for the shine, transparent spray or varnish or whatever. So anyway, I was having this color, so I decided to use this one, and I will color all the bowl, all the leaves, with this dark green oil paint, actually not acrylic paint, sorry. So after it's dry overnight, you can see the gloss, the shine on the leaves. This is all because of the color I used. Anyway, then I took the acrylic paints, light green and yellow color, because it was less quantity. So to highlight the leaves on top of the green, dark green, I decided to highlight the leaves with these light color green shades by mixing the green and yellow together. I got this color. So this is just to highlight the leaves, some texture of the leaves to make them more prominent, and I was quite happy with the dark green color oil paint, because it gave the bowl more smooth and shiny, glossy look, and it made the clay actually very secure and hard instead of having the texture or cracky things on it. And then here I took a lawn yellow color, lemon color, yellow color, something like this, to highlight it more in details. So I was really happy with the texture, with the result, and I'm loving it. I was planning to make more of these things. Actually, I'm planning to make like a jungle type, some trees, like bowl, but not complete round bowl. It will be like a jungle, something vase type. So let's see if I will be doing it soon or later, I don't know. But I was really happy with this, because it was green and it's like nature color, and it's greenery, so I loved it. And you can see after highlighting it, it's giving it more realistic looks of leaves, instead of just leaving it by dark green color. So for the inner part, I'm using black acrylic paint. I will color all the inner part with this color, black acrylic paint. And you can actually use candles inside if you want, of course the battery candles, not the real ones, just to display it in your home. So here we are done. As you can see, the texture, and it was really eye-catching in home, because for me it was really realistic leaves type, and I loved it. And for sure, for the night I can display the candles inside. Remember, the battery candles, not the real ones after you burn it, so don't blame me that I didn't tell that it's battery candles or the fire ones, the real ones. Anyway, I hope you like the video. Thank you so much for watching. Stay watching, keep subscribing, keep sharing, keep supporting, and I'm bringing more sculptures ideas, more bowls like this, and some more different ideas soon. So thank you so much for watching, and bye for now.